Zombie collector?
Anyway, I just thought that the dad from Family Circus looks like the zombie collector in some of the cartoons. I move this out of the way here. Didn't have much in the mail today. It was a pouring rain as of the moment, and I went to a coin show and, you know, drove about a half an hour away. Nothing really outstanding there, but nonetheless, it was a different thing to do. And I'll just get into what I got in yesterday. I got more than a cat coupon on Friday, and today there was, I don't think I got a blessed thing at all, period. I just noticed that I'm missing an eBay package from Australia and an eBay package from Germany. The Australian guy was very nervous because he wanted me to leave feedback as soon as I've gotten it, but that was as of the 20th of last month, and the German thing, I bought from that guy two or three times before, and that was as of the 30th of last month. So who knows what's going on there. Maybe the mail is just really slow, and maybe some has been cherry-picked out of my my mail, because I don't seem to be getting as much as I used to. I don't know what's all going on here, but let's see. So I've got two things, actually three things to show you. This is from former major leaguer Frank Lindsay, and somebody gave me the idea to write to them. I asked if it was so-and-so, and they haven't responded back. I can't remember who gave me the idea. I wanted to get credit them, but nobody has responded yet, so here's Frank Lindsay. More than likely it was Caleb, but if you had recently gotten Frank Lindsay, let me know. This is his probably rookie card. I'm not sure if he had like one of those dual cards like this with a trophy card. I've had this ever since I was a kid, and I never wanted to mail it off or lose it because at the time it was one of my better condition ones with four corners on it. So there's that. It's signed right above the jersey, right across the jersey. And then here's a much later one from 73. Didn't realize he played in the 70s. That was a 67, and this is a 73. And it's harder to see, but, well, I guess it's also across the jersey. What was I thinking that he signed on the bottom? Somebody signed on the bottom in the middle for me. I may have already shown that, hopefully. So there's that one. So that's really cool to have that. I think that came out of Oklahoma, but don't quote me on that. And I had given him a card to have because I was trying to be nice and do something for somebody. Because I don't know a lot about Frank Lindsay's career because he played before I was born. So I thought I would give him his Griffey here. Either he's not a Griffey fan or didn't understand why I sent that. But I had written right on the thing, a gift for you. Maybe he's just not a Mariners fan. But I just thought it would be cool to give him a Hall of Fame baseball card of one of my favorite players in exchange for his autograph, but I guess he figured it would be better in my collection. And that was a duplicate. Now, I went to Dollar Tree last night just to grab a drink, and then I looked at their cards again. Still nothing. Let me move this bowl out of the way. And I have to scoot this away and get this out of here. And sorry about that. I'm kind of holding the camera this time. And I found an empty box that had been there for a super, super long time. And so I bought my drink, and I said, there's nothing in this box. And I was the last one to buy the last two packs and the product. Can I have this? And he talked to the other clerk, and I said, yeah, just give him the box. So if you're a wrestling fan, I have gotten the Gravity Feed box from Dollar Tree, the Topps Heritage 2018 trading cards with the iconic 1989 Topps design, and I know Victor completed the set, and I have only purchased about two packs worth. I think that's all there was. They had a few other random trading card packs there of wrestling that were left over from the Gravity Feed boxes here, but it's got the WWE Divas on the side there. And then these little plastic hooks were in the box, but I believe that they came with that so you could hang that on like a rod type thing and have it floating on a display. And then there's the New Day, I believe, right there. Yeah, it is a New Day right there. I'm kind of out of the loop there. And there's a nice WWE hologram right there. That's really neat. This box is in amazing condition, I think, except for where I dinged it right there, unfortunately. And then it opens up, and that's where the pack's supposed to fall out down there, and then you grab that one. And I kind of, I'm not exactly sure how that fits in there. But I just thought it was a neat display piece, and I got it for free. And I also wanted to free up some of the shelf space that they had there, because they were just What happened is a number of months ago, a whole bunch of these boxes came crashing down. It was very embarrassing. And because there was only like one or two packs in there, if that, people were stashing things that were not card related in there. So I thought I would help them out by getting one of the boxes. And if you have a Dollar Tree and see some of these boxes that they no longer have the product for, probably never will ever get in again, you might want to see if you can purchase those. I mean, purchase those, but, and it helps if you make a purchase to boot, if you don't just walk in there and say, can I have a free box? I don't think they would do that for you. It's like when I was doing the boxes at Toys R Us, the empty boxes, depending on who it was, if any of you bought something, then they gave you the box. Because what are they going to do with it? Throw it directly in the trash. So, and that helps them out and helps you out, and it doesn't hurt anything. And that was probably the best thing that happened over the weekend, is getting this box. So excited to have this, even though I don't have the complete set. And maybe one day I'll finish off the 89 set or the 86 or whatever design that they had there too. So hope you enjoyed that, and thank you for